All right, guys, so here's the 7 things we think every guy should know.
So we had a lot of questions on kind of how to and what to wear, when to wear it, but we just want to do more of a general video and talk to you about 7 things we think every gent should know. And the first one being,
it's always better to be overdressed than underdressed. You don't want to walk into a place when everyone's wearing a tux or everyone's wearing a suit and you're in a pair of jeans.
Yeah, that's honestly the worst. And honestly, it's easier to become equivalent with the with the crowd. If you're overdressed, you can just take off a blazer, take off a tie, you know, like loosen up the collar and you're good. You come in jeans and a t-shirt, there's no way you can
stand out.
You can up your level to that.
Yeah. And you know what, as far as the ladies, I mean, they like a guy who's dressed up.
Number 2.
How to portray your liquor.
It's probably one of the most important things every guy should know. The general rule is you drink the first drink, you sip the second, and you skip the third. And that's like a basic rule for any like business party where you have to kind of like keep it really together and like you don't want to embarrass yourself. But I'd say if you're going to let loose and kind of, you know, get a little buzz going, you want to make sure you know when to stop, because the moment you start becoming an asshole is the moment you never want to get to when you're drinking.
And like this basically comes with age, you know, it's, it's experience.
Trial and error.
Yeah.
You want to try it out with people you're close to, not people that you have to make an impression with.
Just plain and simple, just know the how to drink.
Yeah.
Control. Simple, just know how to portray it.
Exactly. What's number 3?
How to treat a lady. I think I hold this one, you know, pretty dear to me. You know, women are a little bit more special, so you got to be able to open that door, you know, treat them to a nice dinner, know how to make a nice meal for them, and just be a gentleman.
Exactly, simple as that. You got to be a gentleman.
Snap. Which leads us to number 4.
You got to know how to cook. I mean, at least one basic meal for each of the 3 meals of the day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You should know how to make eggs. Omelets are a good go-to in the morning. Pasta is really easy for dinner, and a good salad or sandwich is
an A+.
Yes, exactly.
Something as simple as even a yogurt with granola, with berries, you know, to set it up. You know, you're not really making it, but you know, it's all about the presentation.
If you make it look pretty, it's gonna taste that much better.
Yeah.
So, know how to cook.
And number 5, how to tie your own tie.
Yeah, you gotta know your 3 basic knots, your full Windsor, your half Windsor, and your 4 in hand. And also, know how to tie a bow tie. It's not that hard. You can learn.
Learn, gentlemen.
Yes, it's very important. Especially you go into a meeting, an interview with a crooked, whack-looking tie. It's
no, it's not. And if you need even more help, you can refer to our videos in the past that we have on each of these, where we give a detailed description.
Yeah, we'll put them here. Number 6.
How to hold a conversation.
Have you guys have had that awkward moment where there's just awkward pause between the 2 people and you just don't know what to say, what to talk about? I mean, that just comes with kind of a willingness to learn about another person and to be able to hold a conversation with about, you know, just a little bit on every subject.
Yeah, like, any topic.
Right, you don't, I mean, sports is like probably a good go-to for guys, and I'm not saying you need to know who's playing wide receiver for the Minnesota Vikings, but you should know first down, like what teams are good, what, you know, just a little bit, just so you can kind of pique their interest, and then they'll tell you everything that you want to know about what they care about. You know, like you show a little bit of interest and they'll do the talking. You don't have to do much, but that's kind of a good example on how to get a conversation started and keep it going. I'm not, I'm a Steelers fan.
Steelers fan.
Who are you?
Raider fan. And number 7, which is probably the most essential, is know when to keep your mouth shut.
Exactly.
Like, I think this is something that every guy should know. You know, there's always a time and place. So you know, pick your words wisely and choose when not to say them.
Right. When you're in a group of people and you want to feel out the conversation before you blurt out something that's like maybe offensive to somebody, or like you got to get the vibe of the room before you open your mouth and
really indulge in.
Like you don't want your foot to end up in your mouth is what we're saying.
We've all had it, so let's do our best to avoid it.
So we're all just like, ooh.
Or why did I say that?
Yeah. But, no. I mean, it all comes with experience as well. Like, you kind of learn how to feel out of a situation.
And this goes with everybody. If you're with your friends, your parents, if you're dating, especially if you're dating. Right. You just know when to And that's it, guys. That's our 7 essential things we think every guy should know.
Exactly. Be sure to like us on Instagram, at Gents Lounge. Be sure to subscribe. Hashtag your pictures, hashtag Gents Lounge. And if you had to round out this list to 10, what would be the other 3 things you think every guy should know? Usually, like, when people go to weddings, right, you go out to a bar after the wedding with kind of, like, people.
Yeah.
And every time I go out in to a regular dive bar, like, crazy bar in a suit, I always get, like, so many compliments and people walking up to me kind of talking to me, like, oh, why are you wearing a suit? Like, what do you do?
So
like,
George picks up at bars.
Yeah, I mean...
No, but yeah.
Even,
we're saying,
like, even, like, the guys are like, oh, my God, that's a nice suit, like, sick pocket square, like...
It's so George picks up at bars. No, yeah. No, but you know what? Sorry, dude. I had to go there. That was so good. Because you said even the guys?
Seriously.
Okay. Which leads us to number 4.
What is number 4?
Cooking, dude. That's why I
figured. Yeah. Okay. Go again. I figured. I just didn't want to mess it up. All right. Yeah.
All right.